The International Union for Conservation of Nature, IUCN, is an international organization working in the field of nature conservation and sustainable use of natural resources. It is involved in the data gathering and analysis, research, field projects, advocacy, and education. IUCN's mission is to influence, encourage, and assist societies throughout the world to conserve nature and to ensure that any use of natural resources is equitable and ecologically sustainable. IUCN was established on 5th October 1948 in France when representatives of governments and the conservation organizations signed a formal act constituting the International Union for Protection of the Nature, IUPN. The initiative to set up the new organization came from UNESCO and especially from its first director general, the British biologist Julian Huxley. At the time of its founding, IUPN was the only international organization focuses on the entire spectrum of natural conservation. IUPN started out with 65 members in Brussels and was closely associated to UNESCO. They jointly organized the 1949 Conference on Protection of Nature, Lake Success, USA, and drafted the first list of gravely endangered species. IUPN was successful in engaging prominent scientists and identifying important issues. In 1956, IUPN changed its name to the International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. From 1956 to 1965, the IUCN expanded its relations with UN agencies and established links with the Council of Europe. IUCN's best-known publications, the Red Data Book on the Conservation Status of Species, was first published in 1964. IUCN began to play a part in the development of international treaties and conventions, starting with the African Convention on the Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources. Africa was the first regional focus of IUCN conservation. Africa was the focus of many of the early IUCN conservation field projects. IUCN supported the Yellowstone model for protected area management, which severely restricted human presence and activity in order to protect the nature. The IUCN suffered from restricted financing in its early years. To establish a stable financial basis for its work, IUCN participated in setting up the World Wildlife Fund 1961, now the World Wide Fund for Nature, WWF, to work on fundraising to cover part for the operational cost of IUCN. Also, in 1961, the IUCN headquarters moved from Belgium to Morges in Switzerland. IUCN was one of the few environmental organizations formally involved in the preparations of the United Nations Conference on Human Environment, Stockholm 1972. The Stockholm Conference eventually led to three new international conventions, which IUCN involved in their drafting and implementation. First, the Convention Concerning the Protection of Wild Cultural and Natural Heritage 1972. IUCN co-drafted the World Heritage Convention with UNESCO and has been involved as the official advisory body on nature from the onset. Sites: the Convention on International Trade in Endangered Species of Wild Fauna and Flora, 1972. IUCN is a signatory part and the site's secretariat was originally lodged with IUCN. And the last is Ramsar Convention, Convention on Wetlands of International Importance, 1975. IUCN entered into an agreement with the United Nations Environment Programme, UNEP, to provide regular reviews of world conservation. In 1975, IUCN started work on the World Conservation Strategy, the drafting process, and the discussions with the UN agencies involved led to an evolution in thinking within IUCN and growing acceptance of the fact that conservation of nature by banning human presence is no longer worked. Sustainable Development and Regionalization, 1985 to the present day. In 1982, IUCN set up a Conservation for Development Center within its secretariat. Over the years, it supported the development of national conservation strategies in 30 countries. In 1991, IUCN, together with UNEP and WWF, published Caring for Earth, a successor to the World Conservation Strategy. Social aspects of the conservation were now integrated in IUCN's work. At the General Assembly in 1994, the IUCN mission was redrafted to its current wording to include the equitable and ecologically use of natural resources. Since the creation of IUCN in 1948, IUCN members have passed more than 300 resolutions that include or focus on business-related activities. In 2003, the IUCN established Business and Biodiversity Program. In 2008, IUVN stopped using World Conservation Union as its official name and reverted its name back to the International Union for Conservation of Nature. In 2012, IUCN publishes a list of world's 100 most threatened species. In 2016, IUCN created a new membership category for indigenous peoples organizations. For more such videos, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.